Hey, what's up, YouTube? This is MDDAJ23Fan from JerseyCentral.org coming to you here. I'm going to make this video to talk to you guys a little bit about the Revolution 30 basketball jerseys that are new this year by Adidas. I don't know if a lot of you guys were able to take advantage of this or not, but there was a sale on Modell's for 40% off. As you know, these things are really, really expensive. They retail for between $250 and $270, I think. So they're really pricey, but the 40% off actually made them somewhat doable. So I was able to pick up a few of them with my tax return and things like that. So anyway, I got some of those to show you, give you my thoughts on them, what I think. Show them to you, let you guys, you know, formulate your own opinions. But I'll start off with those, and then I've got a couple other odds and ends at the end, including a bit of a clue that A-Rock requested for what my next video is going to be about, which is probably going to be in another 3 or 4 weeks, but it'll be worth the wait. So I'll start off with the Revolution 30 jerseys. Start off by what they kind of sweeten the package up to try to justify the price tag. Similar to some of the Majestic jerseys, they baseball authentics, they come in this garment bag. So if you buy one of these Revolution 30 authentics, you're going to get this garment bag. It's got a handle at the top. So that you can carry your jersey if you're going on a jersey business trip. And then it's got the three-stripe logo all the way down. It's full length too, as you can see. And of course up here, it has the Revolution 30 logo. It zips open, you know, you can put your jersey in there. Keeps it protected, I guess. And it does have a little space for the hanger too, so it's just like a regular garment bag. Pretty nice, I guess. I don't know how necessary it is, but and I certainly wouldn't pay extra for it, but anyway, they give you one, so that's that. This is the first one here that I'll show you guys. Of course, likely NBA Rookie of the Year, Blake Griffin. And this is the home Clippers jersey. So obviously Blake won the dunk contest. You can see a couple of things I wanted to point out here. You can see on the front the numbers. They are a layer of white twill followed by a layer of red. It's really more the swingman material. It's not even twill. I mean, it has like the appearance of perforation like the players wear, like the mesh material. And then it's satin stitched onto the below white layer twill. You'll notice that the word mark is all twill and it is satin stitched, and then it's actually heat pressed on. The Clippers neck logo is sewn on. The back numbers, you can see, are done in a similar fashion. And this is a big one. You notice the name on the back? Wrong font. So for $270 or whatever it is, they can't even give you the font that they wear on the court, which I think is pretty bad. But probably going to take that off and have it redone at some point in the right font. This font's a little off too. Numbers a little too angular. Their player jerseys are more rounded, but everything else, like the jersey itself, obviously the mesh fabric, you can see the zones where the fabric changes and stuff for heat output, and then the trim, all of the, I mean, the jersey itself is a great product, but I just wish they'd just give me all twill on it, because if you're not going to give me what the players wear, at least give me something that justifies the price tag, and I don't feel like swingman material really does that. So next up is the road version. This is the one Blake wore when he won the dunk contest too. I'll show you the jock tag. I didn't do that on the last one. So I get a 3X, and these gives me enough room to wear them comfortably pit to pit because they run a little narrow. But they are really, really long. So not sure what I'm going to do about that yet, but see all the same details that I showed you before on this one. Nice jersey, and probably likely rookie of the year here, so pick that one up as well. Now, some of you may know I have a collection of All-Star Game jerseys for LeBron James. Not my most favorite player as of recently, but you know, I still gotta give it up to him. And I did decide to go ahead and keep my collection going, even though he's taking his talents to South Beach. So this is the authentic All-Star Game jersey. All they had left when I ordered this was a large, so I had to settle for that, I guess. And so the likelihood of me ever wearing this is slim and none. But you can see it's got the, this is like a plastic All-Star patch. And see the 2011 there. Lots of details on this jersey. The crest is that same kind of plastic material. You can see the cityscape of Los Angeles there. And that's all. This patch is done on twill with like a plastic word mark, and then it's sewn onto the jersey. The is like screen printed or heat pressed on. The numbers are done in a similar fashion. You can see, I don't know if you can see it, but it gives the appearance of the mesh, but it has a navy blue layer of twill that's zigzag stitched on, and then the satin stitching for the silver. This jersey actually doesn't have the heat bands that I showed you on the Griffin. Side panels look like that, and they got the kind of marquee looking side panels, and then you flip to the back and you see the name is single layer twill. The number's done in the same format, just a little different. This really killed me too. The stars actually are individually numbered or individually sewn on to represent his number of all-star selections, but this heat patch, it's a really flimsy plastic. Once again, paying quite a bit for something that kind of has a cheap feel to it, which is too bad. And it also has the sublimated stars on the back. I don't know if you can pick that up, but it's got a little bit of sublimation on the back as well for the star designs. You can pick it up there, but kind of a cool feature. These jerseys didn't blow me away, but again, when he does retire, it'd be kind of nice to have one for, you know, every All-Star game he was in. This one I was pretty excited about. It's a Ray Allen Hardwood Classics jersey. It's their home jersey. This is a 2X. You can see it's got the NBA logo, a little bit different color. It's got the vintage color scheme to it. And everything on this is twill. So I actually, it makes it even nicer in my opinion. No Celtics logo on the back because it's the throwback. And you got, this is all heat pressed. There's no zigzag stitching on there. It's just all heat pressed on. The number does have the zigzag. And then down here, you come down, you get the Hardwood Classics Knights badging and the 2XL tag. This is a really nice jersey. I was super psyched that I was able to pick this up. And this is the jersey Ray Allen was wearing when he broke Reggie Miller's record. So, very glad that I could get that one. Next up is a potential MVP candidate. picked this one up. This was the most recent one, along with another that I'll show you in a minute. And hear everybody talk. Everybody says he's pretty much going to win it hands down. I got the alternate Chicago Bulls, Derrick Rose jersey. Everything on this jersey, like I mentioned, if you look at the name, it's Twill, through and through, all the way down. The number is done in the same fashion, white Twill with the red plastic and the black satin stitch. And then the Bulls logo, actually more patch-like than the All-Star logo, so it's actually a little bit nicer. The front crest is all Twill, but with some satin stitching in there, but it's red Twill. And the front number, same thing. And I was able to get a 3X in this one as well. So MVP candidate, front runner, Derrick Rose alternate.